Every day, millions of Filipinos commute and take public transportation in order to get to their destination. Some students and workers commute every day because they don't have their own vehicles, or they just don't have any other choice. We decided to look into the everyday life of these commuters, specifically of Joanna Sungas, a psychometrician in Assumption College.
How's the traffic every day?
If you leave the house early, there's a tendency that you might miss the traffic, but then there are peak days. Example, if you leave the house around 7, it's already late. So the traffic is kind of terrible, especially in EDSA.
Does it affect your daily schedule at work?
Yes, very much. If the flow in the MRT is not good, there's a tendency that I might be late. So if the flow is really terrible, like example, the MRT, one of the MRT trains broke down, I might have to transfer to a bus, which will take me a bit around 1 hour to 45 minutes, aside from my usual time, which is only 30 minutes or less.
What is your favorite means of commuting?
MRT! No, it's really deadly.
Why?
Because there's a lot of people who use it, especially in the mornings. Even if I arrive at the MRT station around 6:20 or something, there's already a lot of people, so it's really hard for me to tuming it. Yeah, that's the term, tuming it, because there's a lot of people already inside. So if you ride between the spots, like the Cubao station, the North station, there's already full. So in between the stops, it's hard to ride the MRT because there's only a few people to do now.
So how many rides or modes of transportation does it take for you to get from your house to your work?
Usually in the morning, I use three. I use the tricycle, then the bus, then the MRT.
Going home the same?
Going home, no. I only use the MRT and then the tricycle. I just walk to the tricycle station.
Ano yung mga advantages and disadvantages of commuting?
Advantages, madali ka makakaway. Tapos, less time, you can spend time with your family, your friends, tsaka relax time. The disadvantage is, you have to wait for a long time just to be able to ride either a shuttle, either the MRT, or the bus.
Lately, ang daming mga reports of like bus accidents, ganon. After watching the news, kinakabahan ka like to commute pa or what?
May times kasi na yung mga bus, maharurot sila. Tapos pag bumababa ako sa, example, sa San Colon Station, bumababa ako, sa gitnahan nila binababa. So yun yung nakakatakot dun kasi hindi mo alam kung yung kasunod. Tapos dun, aside from the buses that I use, I also use a tricycle. So minsan yung takbo talaga nila mapibilis. Yun yung problem ngayon, lalo na sa mga nagdadrive. Hindi sila marunong sumunod sa mga rules and regulations. Sobrang sila mabilis, tapos hindi nila tinitingnan yung mga katabi nilang kotse.
Does it make you want to stop commuting or okay lang pa rin?
Okay lang. Though it's kind of risky, but then that's the only means of, my only means of going to work. So that's going to other places as well. So I think that you should just take caution.
Naka-experience ka na ba ng accident or near-death experience because of the commuting?
Commuting? Dami na. Nababa ako sa gitna ng daanan. So may time na hindi ko napansin yung nasa likod na taxi. So, bigla siyang dumaan. Buti na lang, nakaulong agad ako. Kung hindi, nasagasaan ko nila. Itinder yung pa ako. Tapos other than that, sa jeep na sinasakyan ko, masyado mabilis yung takbo niya. Tapos, hindi niya na-press agad yung brake. Yung jeep na papunta dito, hindi kan sila magbanggaan.
Was there ever a time na hinakawan ka or hinold up on while commuting or sa jeep?
Marami na eh. Sa MRT, nawalan ako ng iPod. iPod, nawalan siya. Hindi ko na malaya na nadukot na pala siya sa bag ko. Tapos, nakaaway marami na lalo na sa MRT. Since sobrang siksikan siya, wala kang choice kundi pagpasensya na, pero pag sobrang pagod ka na, papaaway ka talaga.
So do you think that the government should take action in making the modes of transportation better for the commuters because of the disadvantages?
Yes, I think so, because in the MRT, of course, my means of transportation, it's really hard to fit all the people in the trains. So I think we have to at least buy another set of trains, yeah, as well as put up regulations like there's only a limit on entering the MRT, or at least have a time frame, because it's really hard riding the trains if it's always full. As well as for the buses. Of course, the buses, they have to have the right pit stop so that the passengers will be able to ride them safely without the dangers of getting run over, or at least getting stuck in traffic.
So that it's more organized.
Yeah.
These are the people who have to survive the pollution, crowded vehicles and terminals, as well as the hustle and bustle of commuting in order to get to where they need to be and do what they have to do for the day. Commuting in Manila is a matter of life or death. Unlike countries like Singapore, the bus drivers and vehicle operators' main concern is profit, which comes first before the passengers' comfort, convenience, and safety. Aside from the chaotic traffic and undisciplined drivers in Metro Manila, there is also the concern of crime in the urban areas of the country. Everyone living here, foreign or local, must raise their awareness at all times in order to be safe when driving and in commuting especially. If only the authorities in the country can see the struggles these commuters face every day, then maybe something can be done to improve their lifestyles and lessen the stress they are confronted with.